I started this YouTube channel a little over a year ago. I didn't start it to gain any notoriety or to become famous. I didn't plan on getting thousands of subscribers or hundreds of thousands like Chase on Two Wheels or Do It With Dan or Hero RR or any of those guys who have a very large subscriber base. I did this just to talk about stuff in general, give people a little bit of entertainment, talk about riding, talk about motorcycles. I try to keep my page politically free. I don't want to talk about a lot of hot button issues like gun rights or gun control or politics or abortion or any of that stuff. I didn't want to turn into a page where it's opinionated for one side or the other about anything. And I've also not talked about certain like life-changing events such as relationships and love and those kinds of things. But today's video is going to break that just a little bit because of recent events of yesterday for me. I lost a good friend and a guy that I knew for quite a long time. It was over 13 years and his name was Steve and I worked with him for a long time. He was a really great guy overall. And he died unexpectedly. It's nothing like this that ever happens. You never plan on someone dying or expect anyone to die. And when they do, it always hits you really hard. And I just think that what everyone's going through that knew him is probably still in shock right now. I don't think it's really even fully hit me yet. And I don't know when it will, but I just know that it's something that's really hard to deal with because he's someone that I spent a lot of time with over 13 years. I mean, I knew him well at work. We did a lot of things together, had a lot of conversations about stuff. And when someone's just gone like that, you don't really know how to take it, I guess. And I haven't had to deal with death a lot. What I have had to deal with has mostly been from people that I've known at work, and it's just always a really hard thing to try and deal with. So I guess my way of trying to cope with this is just to be on the bike and kind of ramble on about what's going through my head about it, because I don't know if I'm ready to talk about it with people yet that I know. I've talked to about it with people that are not associated with my work, and that's helped, but I haven't done what I've had to do on my own yet to really come to grips with all of this shit. Steve was a really good guy. He had strong beliefs in a lot of things that he always believed for himself and never backed down on. And it's really hard to put into words everything really, but I guess everyone's gonna remember him in their own way. People that may not have known him for very long, but then there are those of us who knew him for 10 years or more, 15, 20 years, and then those are the people that his family and stuff that knew him his entire life. I can't imagine what they're going through right now. And it kind of puts everything into perspective, life in general and everything else, because it's so fragile and it's gone so quick. It makes you realize that you only have one go at all of this. You can't go back and change things. You can't hit the reset button. You can't... It's not a video game. You can't turn it off and turn it on again. You can't have your friend come and revive you if you die. It doesn't work like that. You can't take for granted what you have. And you can't live life in the past. You can't hold grudges, and you can't... You can't assume that... You can't assume that everything that you planned for, that you've wanted to do, is always going to happen. I'm at the point where I want to accomplish things and do things that I've always wanted to do and talked about for years. Because you just never know. I mean, I don't want to go through my life with regrets or not doing things that I wish I had done. I certainly hope that Steve was able to do all the things that he had wanted to do. He was taken way too soon. He was only 46, and it's only 7 years older than I am, and it's just hard to come to grips with someone that was taken way too soon. And yeah, I know that on my end, I don't want to live having regrets or not doing things that I've always wanted to do. And everyone's going to remember Steve in their own way. I am not going to remember Steve for his uniform. I am not going to remember him for his badge. He was much more than that, and he deserves a lot more than that. He was an individual and a person with a great personality. I don't think a job in a uniform defines who you are. He was who he is without any of that. And that's just how I'm going to personally remember him. It's truly sad that he's gone. And I know that everyone's going to go through the grieving process and the sadness for what's happened. But I also know that Steve wouldn't want people to dwell on his death for the long term. He was a really happy individual. He was always in a great mood whenever I talk with him and spend time with him. And I know that's how he would want everyone else to be as well. I'm not sure exactly how he died yet. The only thing that's really known is that he went off the road with his truck and he hit a tree. The cause of that has yet to be determined because it's all still really new. I'm sure everything will come to light within the next few days. Regardless of how it happened, it's still just an incredible loss, and as time passes, it will get easier, but there's a lot of people out there with heavy hearts right now, and it's going to take a while for normalcy to return. You spend a lot of time with the people that you work with, and there are people that I call friends that I haven't seen in years, but the people that I work with, I spend more time with them and I know them better than people that I spend time with out of work and that I call friends. So it's just a really odd situation overall. I don't know where you are now, Steve, but I hope that you have found peace and happiness wherever you may be. You will be missed by many, and Godspeed to you, and rest well, my friend.